In this video, I will explain how you can use HTML and JavaScript to build dynamic prompts for SAS Viya Jobs. In an earlier video, I demonstrated how you can build the same kind of prompts using task prompt and the command task model. Let me start with a small introduction, just in case you have not watched the earlier video. I will start explaining what are the SAS Viya Jobs. You will then see what are the HTML prompts and how they can be used for SAS Viya Jobs. The SAS Viya Jobs provide functionalities that are similar to the ones of the SAS 9 stored process. SAS Viya Jobs are executed from the web through HTTP requests. The requests are sent to the SAS job execution endpoint. Behind the scene, the jobs are executed on the SAS compute server, which is launched by the launcher server. You can build the jobs using SAS Studio or the SAS Job Execution web application, SAS Studio being the preferred option. If you are familiar with the SAS 9 stored processes, the GES begin and GES end autocall macros will be familiar to you. They were named STP begin and STP end in SAS 9. A job is a combination of different objects. A job prompt written in the HTML or XML languages. A job definition which contains the information about the prompt to use, the parameters, and also the SAS code. The job parameters are used to pass data from the prompt or from the URL to the SAS code. I will now explain what are the HTML prompts and how you can use them. So the prompts are used to interact with the end user. When the user launches a job, you can, as a developer, ask him to pass information to the job. The information request is a form. The form contains fields and a submit button. In the earlier video, we have seen how to create the prompts with a layout and the dependencies using XML. This time, it is using the HTML language and JavaScript. When you create your prompt, you can bind the HTML file to the job definition, or you can point to an external file stored in the SAS content. In SAS Viya Stable Release 2021.1.2, the HTML dynamic data prompts were introduced. This is done using JavaScript and jQuery. The features allow by embedding the two script files to retrieve data from tables, but also list libraries and tables. To achieve this, SAS provides the extra data attributes. Let me show you a demo of the functionality. If you have seen the earlier video, you may notice that the XML and HTML prompts are having the same look and feel. Let's now dive into the code. For the SAS code, I've been using the same code as in my previous presentation. The SAS code, I will copy it from GitHub. So you will have the link to GitHub with this video and create a new job definition within SAS Studio. For the job definition, I paste the code I've selected. You see here, just for information, that we have created multiple macro variables for statements. These statements are used to filter the data in a proc print. We are using the SAS helpcars table. We see that here we have var origin, var type count, var drive terrain, and var invoice. These are variables that will be passed using the HTML form. Talking about the HTML form, I will embed an HTML form by just selecting this option. I can minimize it and select the HTML that we have in Git repository. I will select all the content. As you can see here, we have around 100 lines of code. This is the complete code that we need to integrate. Let me describe what the code is. So we have the usual start HTML definition. We have the head section, and in the head section, you define a viewport to make sure that you are displaying on the full size of your screen. You can also define a title for your web page. And then you define the two script files that we have seen and that are provided by SAS. These script files are located in the SAS job execution. So they are resources that are made available to you by SAS, and they are available on every installation. We have then some styling. The styling is to define a nice layout or similar layout to what we have done with the XML version. We are defining this style, and then finally we have the body. In the body, we are loading the body, and when we are loading the body, we are using the SAS dynamic init, and this JavaScript function will initialize all the data objects or data attributes that we need to use. We are defining a form, and in the form we define an action. The action is to call the SAS job execution. We pass two hidden parameters, one underscore program and one underscore action. The underscore program is the name of your program, but you have here the possibility to make that automatic. And then you have the execute action on the job. You have finally the submit button that will be used to submit the form. Our form has multiple sections, and one of the sections is about geography. In the geography, we are specifying a label, and we are using the var origin as the name and the ID. This creates the link with the SAS code. So we are naming the HTML tags with the same name as our macro variables in the job, in the code. Then we have the var origin. We say data col name, specifying which name is the which column is the source of your prompt or your dropdown. We have data library, specifying the library where the data are stored, and the table, data table, where the data is coming from, the table, the class table. Then we have another section. In the other section, this is about cars characteristics, and in there we have var type, which is pointing to the column in the data type, SAS help and cars being the source table. And we here we are using data uses to indicate that we want this prompt element to be filtered by the var origin also. So when you will change the selection on the var origin, it will impact the var type or the type selection. The same applies for the drivetrain, but in that case, what we want to do is we want to filter, but using the var origin and also the var type. So we are filtering by two variables. The last section is about the financial aspect. And in the financial aspect, we define an input range, a slider, based on var invoice, so that's the name. And we want to also filter it using the origin, but that's not required. We have the minimum, maximum, and defined value, and the step for that option. Here, we are defining another choice, which is data visible. Using the data visible, we can tell that if the var origin selection is equal to Asia, we display this section. If this is not the case, we will not display the section. Over here, the last bit is about the var invoice. We are adding an event listener to display the value in the form that was selected for the range. Let's save our code. And now we can start the execution. By executing, we are compiling the HTML page, and the HTML page is displayed in the preview pane. Behind the scene, we are populating the different objects, and we've seen here that we don't have the financial aspect section. Let's see what is happening. The job is collecting data from the server. If I select Europe, I see here a subselection. If I select USA, my selection change. If I select here Sedan, then I have all. If I select SUV, I don't have, and I can also do multiple selections. If I change my selection here to Asia, you see that I get the financial aspect and I can set the price range. That's the maximal value for the price. Now it's time to submit my job. I will do a selection over here and execute it. You see the result, and that's the end of our demo. You can find more information on this topic in the SAS Job Execution User's Guide. In the documentation, there is a specific section around creating HTML forms with dynamic data. Multiple blogs and videos are also covering the topic, and they will help you better understand how SAS Viya Jobs can be used in SAS Viya. Thanks for watching, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.